So now consider this particular beautiful garden. It has been told to us that this garden is in the shape of a parallelogram. And we have been given two sides of the parallelogram, side A and side B. Now we know that in a parallelogram, opposite sides are always equal. So if this side is equal to A, then this side will also be A. Similarly, if this side is B, this side will also be B. Now, how can we find out the perimeter? Very simple. The perimeter will be A plus B plus A plus B, which is nothing but 2A plus 2B. And taking 2 common, we get 2 into A plus B. So for a parallelogram, given two particular sides, the length of two sides, adjacent sides, that is, we can get the perimeter as 2 multiplied by A plus B, that is these two sides. Now let us consider another problem. The problem over here is Mrs. Verma, this lady, she is renovating her store. And in order to renovate her store, she needs a carpet for her floor. Now it has been given that this particular floor of Mrs. Verma's store is parallelogram in shape. And in order to cover this parallelogram shaped floor, she needs a carpet. So in other words, she will need to know the area of the carpet she needs. In order to know that, she will have to find out the area of the given floor. Or in other words, the area of a parallelogram. So we found out how to find the perimeter of a parallelogram. Let us see how we can calculate the area of a parallelogram. So over here we have considered a parallelogram, the same parallelogram of Mrs. Verma's store, the floor, and we have divided it into three particular parts. With the help of these two lines, from here we drop a perpendicular on this point, and from here we drop a perpendicular on this point, thus dividing the parallelogram into three parts. And we find that we get three different shapes. This triangle, this rectangle, and this triangle. Now if you observe closely, triangle 1 and triangle 3 are right angle triangles, because as I mentioned, we have dropped perpendiculars on these points. And figure 2 is a rectangle. Now over here we have to find out the area of the parallelogram. So how can we do that? For this, we have to sum up the areas of the individual figures we have obtained. So let us find out the area of figure 1. The area of figure 1 will be half into base, that is B1, into height, that is 20, plus the area of the rectangle, which is 20 into B2, 20 into B2, plus the area of this particular figure, that is also a right angle triangle. So this will be half into base, that is B3, into height, that is also 20. So from this, I can take 20 common. I take 20 common, and what am I left with? I am left with half B1 plus B2 plus half B3. So from this, I can say that 20 into half B1 plus B2 plus half B3 will give me the area of the entire parallelogram. Now observe this particular figure again closely. If you see this figure closely, we have studied that opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal in length. So when I am considering dropping a perpendicular from this point as well as dropping a perpendicular from this point, these two sides, that is B1, this segment, and B3, this particular segment, will be equal. So this will give me half B1 plus half B3 That is half of this plus half of this as one particular value. So in other words, I will be able to get this half b1 plus half b3 plus b2 as the entire side. That is this particular side, which is 30 meters. So how can I write the area of the parallelogram now? I will be able to write the area of the parallelogram as base into height. Now we have studied that this particular side is known as the base of parallelogram. And since opposite sides are equal, this side is also equal to 30 meters. So the area of the parallelogram will be nothing but 30 into 20 equal to 600 meters square. Thus, Mrs. Verma would need a carpet of area 600 meters square in order to lay it on the floor of a store so as to renovate her store.